Hi, I'm Cynthia Ariosta here in Fort Bragg, California at the Mendocino Coast Botanical Gardens. And I'm here today with Marianne Payne. She's the Executive Director of the Botanical Gardens. She's going to tell us a little bit more about what we're going to see. Hi, Marianne.
Hi, Cynthia. Welcome.
Thank you so much. Hey, can you tell us a little bit more about this incredible flower land and stuff we're going to see on our tour today?
Well, the gardens began about 50 years ago when the Schaefer family opened the gardens, their garden, to the public. Since then, we've added acreage, and now it goes all the way from Highway 1 to the ocean. Gardens are most known for their rhododendron collection, but beyond that, the dahlia garden is certainly a favorite, and we also have begonias and fuchsias, which are quite beautiful.
It's dog-friendly here, am I correct?
It is dog-friendly, and we enjoy it, and the dogs do too.
Here we are in the cactus and succulent garden with Tom Tillotson, the head gardener here at the Mendocino Coast Botanical Gardens. Hi, Tom.
Hi, Cynthia.
So tell me the key areas that... that you really enjoy and you think visitors to the Botanical Gardens really enjoy when they're here?
Well, the first area you come into is the perennial garden, and that is absolutely spectacular. As you progress towards the ocean, which is about half a mile from here, it tends to get wilder and wilder. So between the highway and the ocean, we have the perennial garden, beautiful cactus and succulent garden, the heather garden, which is our probably best collection at this time. We have rhododendrons, hundreds and hundreds of rhododendrons, a beautiful dahlia garden, and we also have a vegetable garden and a children's trail.
So many places to go look at. Let's go check them out.
Mendocino Coast cactus and succulents are rather difficult to grow. What you need is a warm site that has excellent drainage, and that's exactly what we have here. The gardens itself is built on an old sand dune. This is a 100,000-year-old sand dune that we're on top of. So where we are, the soil is very sandy and it has excellent drainage. This is the one area in the gardens where we could successfully grow all these cactus and succulents.
Are there any, you know, key cactuses here, species you'd like to point out?
Well, they've all attacked me at one time or another. I don't have any particular favorites.
So where are we now?
This is our heath and heather collection. This is what you more associate with the foggy Mendocino Coast. These grow in a very narrow band up and down the coast, and this is one of our premier collections.
Can you tell us a little bit about the different species and different types that are here?
Well, we have ericas and we have calunas. Erica is heath, and that's what's blooming right now. And then we have caluna, which is a summer bloomer. And right now we're pruning those back a little bit.
Why do these do so well here?
Well, they like the coolness. These are not heat-tolerant plants. So with our cool coastal fog, it's perfect conditions for them.
What are we going to see next?
Oh, let's go down and look at rhododendrons.
Can't wait. No, but these are one of the main attractions at the Botanical Gardens.
Yes, and these particular rhododendrons, these are species rhododendrons, and we are the only botanical garden that can grow these. We are actually warmer than the Botanical Garden in San Francisco, and of course we're warmer than the gardens north of us. So these we call the tender species rhododendrons, and they do very, very well here.
Are they native to this area?
Mostly native to China.
So this is the edible garden, am I correct?
This is the Mendocino Coast Botanical Garden vegetable garden.
And what happens with all these fabulous edibles? Who gets them?
Well, the volunteers who work here certainly get to take whatever they want. Strawberries and raspberries, it seems like the children get all of them. I haven't had a strawberry in 5 years. Beyond that, we supply the food bank, the hospitality house, and the Presbyterian church for their Thanksgiving dinner.
That's a lot of vegetables. How much is growing here?
Well, we have a lot growing here. We provide about 1,500 pounds of vegetables.
1,500 pounds? That's a big garden.
Yeah, it's a lot, yes.
What here in the children's area then?
This is the children's discovery trail. We put this in last year, and we wanted an area that children could explore and play at.
And all these signs, tell us a little bit about those.
Well, the signs were made by local artist Sev Ikes, and notice none of the signs have any words on them. What we want to do is inspire the children to look, to feel, and to play.
I love it.
This is the Children's Fairy Village. You can see it's all built with materials found on site. It's all.
This is the natural area of the Botanical Gardens where I'm standing in a bull pine? A shore pine. See, I am botanically challenged. I don't even know my trees and I live here. We made it all the way to the Pacific Ocean, 47 acres. And you can do this too at the Mendocino Coast Botanical Gardens. We'll see you here.